you, Andy.
Screw this game.
I'll get it.
What happened?
This guy was hit by a car.
Let me see.
I think he needs to go to the hospital. Get a CT scan. You know what that is? No?
A CT scan is a test that doctors run for patients to pinpoint like a certain head trauma. But I think he won't be able to run the risk of attaining subdural hematoma.
I read about it
on WebMD yesterday.
Here, call an ambulance.
Okay.
Alright.
Oh my god, it's Patrick Matthews.
The governor's son?
The one and only.
You must be Andy Lender. My son's in stable condition. County Hospital. This is my bodyguard. I understand the accident happened right here. That's what the doctor said. Your friends called up. They told me you were responsible for saving my son. I appreciate that. Genius comes from rare places. Let me tell you something. We're very lucky that you were here today. My son and myself, thank you very much. Oh, by the way, tomorrow's newspaper, headline, young hero saves governor's son. You'll be hearing from me.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Back to the car. It's a pleasure, Andy.
That was the governor. He gave me my compliments. He gave me this when he shook my hand. What?
We're trying to figure out why the governor's son was here without any bodyguards.
I've been thinking that too. And tomorrow's re-election day, and that's when he should be with his father the most.
You're a town hero, and that's great. But if you figured out who hit Patrick, I bet that would make you a national hero.
So you figured, now that I aimed my hand at medicine, I should now direct it to criminology?
While you're young, kid.
I'm gonna go see what's going down. Go pay a visit to the governor.
No. I'm in my outdoor office for the campaign here in the park. Yeah. All right, I'm gonna hand you over to my secretary now. Judy, line 3.
The secretary said I might find you here, because you weren't at your campaign headquarters.
Well, I'm here, and Andy. I have a little expression in my world. You don't go to bed with someone until you get to know them. So I want to get to know you a little better, and I actually have your transcript over here. I can't believe this. It shows you're a high school dropout. It says you dropped out, got into fist fight with teenagers, hung out with a dope smoke crowd. I mean, you know, my experience with you is you got a vast sense of knowledge.
Well, yeah, my past is none of your concern.
No, I disagree. I'm the governor. I make my own rules. And as far as I'm concerned, your future is now something that's important to me. And your past is my concern if it is my concern. And I'll make that decision because I am the governor.
Well, governor, what I came to tell you about was, you know, your son, Patrick, you went to see him at the hospital. But I find it a little odd that you came down and you didn't even ask what happened to him. You looked like you just had all your lines prepared, and that was a real nice act that you pulled, I just got to say. Because what I believe is that it wasn't an accident. Because I find it really weird that there really wasn't an investigation. I mean, it all just sort of blew away.
What are you trying to say? What are you trying to say? I'm the governor.
I'm just saying... I think there's more to it than I think you're trying to tell me. I think you're covering something.
You know, Andy, I'm going to tell you something. You just gave away your greatest weapon.
Yeah.
Plausible deniability.
Wait, here you come.
Police, that's who I'm calling.
Why?
Because...
You have nothing on me.
Yeah, I do. When my son was hit, he didn't make that call. And we call that obstruction of justice. So
you
I'm going to make that call. I'm going to make that call right now.
You're not getting down... You're not going down that effect. They let you out of the hospital already?
Oh, you're the guy that saved my life.
You don't seem sort of curious as to why your father, the governor, didn't leave any bodyguards with you? I mean, don't you think that he might want something to happen to you?
Stop dribbling the ball.
This is serious, all right? All right. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to get you all shook up here. Let's just take a walk. I gotta tell you something. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to get you all shook up over there. I'm just saying, I care about you, Patrick. I do. I care about you. I don't really know you all that well, but I know that you don't deserve what's happening here, okay? I mean, aren't you even in the least curious as to who hit you?
Well.
Because I think it was someone on your governor's staff. Did you see anything? I know you blacked out, but before, did you see, like something that we can use to find out who it might have been? Did you see, like, something, on the back of what they were wearing, like what they were wearing, or do you see something on their hand?
I think he had a tattoo.
Wait, stop. Do you, this is very important, do you know what was on that tattoo?
The Statue of Liberty.
I'm so pleased, I want to thank you both. You got my back, you got my front. Thank you both.
The three wise men, huh?
What are you doing back here?
Can we have some privacy? Or especially him, out because...
John, you're excused. Can you just give me a little time here?
I saw he had a Statue of Liberty tattoo on his arm.
You're not ruining this day for me.
All right.
People depend on me. I'm the governor of New Jersey.
Well, I just wanted to tell you that I got you subpoenaed and you're under arrest.
And I'm not going to have my son ruin my campaign. That kid was shouting fire. That kid was throwing up tantrums all over the place. He had to go. I can't even look at my own son.